Synchromysticism, the art of attributing dynamic context to space-time phenomena, allowing patterns, themes, and insight to arise out of a new web of connections.
My God, it's full of stars.
Movie stars are as below resonators of the skies above. Their earthly movements through the silver screen reflect the drama told by the heavens. Kurt Russell as Snake Plissken flies his plane towards the Twin Towers in Escape from New York. Snake wears an eye patch in resonance with the all-seeing and injured eye of Horus, son of Osiris. An ancient circular mandala of extraterrestrial origin that opens cosmic portals is discovered in Egypt. The first human to step through the Stargate is our synchromistic World Trade Center rebirth god, Kurt Russell. All time-space distorting phenomena in pop culture and extraterrestrial themes can be interpreted as symbols or pointers of cosmic consciousness. Synchromistically, in many contexts, pillars, towers, pyramids, and mountains can become interchangeable. On the first degree Freemasonic tracing board, we find three pillars that resonate and might even originate from the three great pyramids of Giza. These pillars also represent two flanking the entrance of Solomon's Temple, which in turn recalls the World Trade Center. In a synchromistic way of thinking, we can go as far as stating the Twin Towers represent the two major pyramids of Giza. Sometimes I call the Trade Towers pyramids.
Said that was an Egyptian symbol.
Yeah, the Eye of Ra.
Robin Tunney climbs the second tallest summit on the planet, K2, in the 2000 film Vertical Limit.
Dad.
Not kidding, Annie. Nobody's going anywhere until you put another cam in the wall.
Dad, I have three cams. It's just yanking your chain.
We got amateurs at 12 o'clock. Check your safety.
There's so much light. It's not gonna hold.
Congrats.
They needed someone who could climb K2 and look presentable. Wasn't exactly a rush.
Author Ralph Ellis decodes the Great Pyramid as a map pointing towards the Himalayan K2 for unknown reasons. Infamous occultist and mountaineer Aleister Crowley was part of the first serious attempt at scaling this ice giant. Synchromistic K2 mountaineer Robin Tunney dabbles in the occult sciences in The Craft, an alternate name for Freemasonry. She is caught in frame with a book titled Magic. This is the spelling devised by Crowley for his method, and the book in question might even be one of his grimoires. She resonates Isis, the mother of Horus, by stepping into the goddess's symbol, the pentagon, and interacting with imagery of the Christianized version of Isis, Mary, mother of God. In 1993's Super Mario Bros., we see one of the Twin Towers partly destroyed, resonating 9/11.
Where do we start?
May I help you? King Koopa here.
A neon double K for King Koopa echoing the K2 mountain can be seen atop one of the intact towers. The K's are fashioned after thunderbolts, connecting them to Zeus, whose Roman counterpart is Jupiter. As the tower is a synchromistic pyramid, and the Great Pyramid has been suggested as a map pointing at K2, the symbolism starts to suggest our associations as resonating soundly. In End of Days, Arnold Schwarzenegger appears in shot with the twin pyramids or towers. He has to protect Robin Tunney, who is to be the vessel for Lucifer's 2K, resonating K2, Millennium Moonchild.
She's been chosen. He's in her blood. The Holy Church has been searching for you since the day you were born.
Chosen for what?
Every 1,000 years on the eve of the millennium, the dark angel comes and takes a body, and then he walks the earth looking for a woman who will bear his child. It all has to happen in that unholy hour before midnight on New Year's Eve.
2000 body over.
This amulet is from a Masonic order and a former sub-herald of the Vatican Knights.
In one scene, Arnold shows Tunney a pierced heart. This mimics the famous image for love, the heart pierced by an arrow. Sagittarius's arrow is aimed at the heart of our galaxy, making this image resonate alignment with galactic center. This birth of the Antichrist through Tunney is the symbolic story of humanity's rebirth, having been distorted with themes of darkness by the ego.
Shot through the heart, and you're too late, darling, you give love a bad name, bad name, bad
name. Right between the twin towers, inside a circular fountain, stood a sculpture called the Spherical Caryatid, intended by the architect to reflect the black cuboid Kaaba at the heart of Mecca. We see the sculpture at the end of a yellow brick road, surrounded by pyramid shapes and decorated with the O and Z for Oz. Crowley wrote Liber Oz, originally the Book of the Goat, Oz resonating the Hebrew for goat or Pan. We can think of Pan meaning whole or totality. Another famous black 2 kilometer or 2K in length cuboid opens the stargate at Jupiter in 2001, A Space Odyssey. The Millennium Hilton Hotel, a replica of Kubrick's monolith, stood flush with the towers as humanity's stargate or rapid ascension was kicked into full gear in the same year as the events portrayed in the film.
This evening at 9 o'clock.
The symbolism of the Sagittarian arrow, which pierces the galactic heart, resurfaces in the name of the character who travels through the Jupiter Stargate, Dave Bowman.
This is Milson, switching to K2 in 5 seconds. Mars.
The Cosmic Consciousness Stargate opens yet again as a mirror atop the towers in the Gargoyles episode, Mirror. First aired on the 11th of September, 1995. Robin Tunney, K2 Mountaineer and 2K Millennium Moonchild Vessel, like Alice, steps through the looking glass stargate in the craft. She represents Isis, heart of the galaxy and humanity's awakening into cosmic consciousness. In August, she has taken her rightful place, the center of the galaxy representing Holiest of Holies between the pillars or symbolic Solomon's Temple. The heart of the cosmos, symbolized by Robin Tunney, coming into alignment alongside Josh Hartnett. We bear witness to a miracle, the madness of the World Trade Center disaster transmuted into consciousness, being becoming aware of itself through synchronicity and us.